So, this is the 3C model of coaching. Okay, so cognition, competence, and character. So this is the total footballer philosophy. So we're going to develop footballers. There are technical players. They're capable of doing things. You can see ball control, movement, positional play, principles of play, system of play. Okay, and then we're going to develop players who are intelligent players, cognitive skills. So we're going to develop them. Okay, and six areas that I'm going to get into here shortly: perception, conception, decision, okay, deception, execution, and assessment. Okay, and then the character. We're going to develop responsible footballers, leaders, right? Positive, respectful, dedicated, reflective, resilient. You know, you can change some of those things to fit, okay, some of the values that you have. Okay, so, and again, you don't have to take this, all of it. If you learn something from our time together and it can apply to your coaching, great. Okay, so, and then we have healthy habits, you know, lifestyle, you know, how you sleep, study, exercise, nutrition. Okay, so a quick example, there was some years ago, Messi had won the best player in the world twice. He had a season that he kind of really struggled. I mean, he wasn't keeping up with the numbers or the goals and that he had. Okay, and before going into the next season, okay, it was the year before they won the Champions League. They struggled. You know, he didn't have this best year. You know, so you could see a clear drop. One of the things that he worked with was his doctor and nutritionist was just watching what he eats, his diet. You know, obviously he's got a lot of resources, but you know, a lot of times they, you know, eating a lot of pizza, for example. So he made a goal, he limited himself to how much pizza, you know, not eat as much pizza. Small details. So, and especially the higher you go in the game, you know, some of you know this, the details are very important. We have a value within our team that we talk about is, you know, anybody play poker? Know what that is? The game, poker? No?
Not so much?
Yeah. Okay, it's a poker term. We can maybe explain it later, but it's kind of, you bet all in, okay? You attack the 1%, and so you're committed, but you pay attention to details. So it's very important to have healthy habits. Okay, so as you go into the slide that talks about the six steps of cognitive process. Okay, so we have get into this here, so you understand the cognitive process. Okay, so we're going to get into the six steps. But a lot of us are used to, I come from a school or a philosophy of football growing up in Brazil that we play on the streets, we do futsal, but a lot of coaches that I've been under, we do a lot of technical work, right? So Jason, come up here, you know, it's a lot of repetition. You know, I don't know if you've had coaches that said in the U.S. is very common. A lot of coaches will say you have to learn how to pass the ball before you can play. Okay, so you know, if he's standing there, you can stand there, that's okay. So if him and I are gonna practice passing. Okay, so he has the ball, okay, so he passes me the ball, I receive and I pass, he receives and passes. Okay, so a lot of times you do that in practice. You have more players, you have a diamond, you can do different patterns. Okay, so what you have there, okay, it's a technical centric approach. So it's very focused on the technical aspect of the game. So in Brazil, you do tons of repetition, right? You do a lot of things where I have the ball in my hand, okay? There, thigh, chest, header, okay? So And that's good. There's a time and a place. So the cognitive process is a process, okay, that from the start, okay, you get the player thinking. Because right now, okay, if we do this, all we're doing is executing. Okay? We can execute and assess. We'll get to it in a second. So because the six-step process, okay, so here, passing and receiving, okay, no pressure. You execute and you evaluate. That's what you can do. You're executing, okay? These elements right here are not part of the process, okay? Now, and this is something we can show, hopefully Wednesday before the match, maybe we can lead the warm-up, talk with Ruben and the captains and the guys, so we can kind of do a quick model of what this is. And I think some of you have seen it. You know, anybody familiar with Rondo? What Rondo is? So I'll show you here. Okay.
Rondo.
So 4-5-2, you know, there's a word keep away where you get two guys in the center, right? So
monkey in the middle. Monkey in the middle. Monkey in the middle.
Monkey in the middle. That's how we say it here in Nepal. Right? So we have so we have that's a Real Madrid, right? On the field. Right? Right?
Okay. What is that now?
That's a monkey in the middle. It's a fun activity, right?
Right.
And sometimes we think it's something we do before we start practice. Oh, we're messing around, we're playing, we're having fun, right? And then practice starts, right? And then we'll go do our dynamic or, you know, do whatever we're going to do. So in Brazil, you know, grew up like that too. We did something similar called bobinho, you know, but the bobinho is like the fool, you know, you're in the middle. You make the mistake, you're the fool, you're in the middle, right? So, and we play, but, you know, learning what Spain and Johan Cruyff and Barcelona, they take it very seriously, Rondo. And you watch, you know, if you have access, I mean, YouTube these days, you can see a lot of practice, okay? But you see why, I mean, they do a lot of it. And sometimes, yes, they're having fun, it's a day before games, the day of a match they're doing. But also, the days of preparation, preseason, middle of the week, they do it every day, okay? So you won't see a lot of this, okay? Where I grew up was more of the technical here, okay? And the big reason is so that you get the player thinking, it changes everything. Because you have defenders, right? So it's small-sided, risk of injury is minimum. You can do it from the start of practice. Okay, so that's something that now, okay, it's not only a technical element in there, but also you have to think, right? This process is part of it. You have to perceive, you have to conceive, okay, you have to decide, deceive, execute, and evaluate. Right? So, you know, it's about positioning angle, it's a very tight space. Okay, so, and there's progressions of that. So they take it very seriously and then they progress into positional play. Okay, so I'm taking you through here a little the model that's used, you know, Barcelona first team, 9-year-olds, same practice, same pattern, same model. Coaches saying, understand, this is how they're going to teach, okay? And all over Spain, okay? And I think, you know, you started to see, you know, you get Brazilian players, doing this in positional play and training games, we can play simple football. The best players, you know, Johan Cruyff says, the best player is the one that keeps the ball, right? 75% of the goals in the game of football, okay, happens on transition. Okay, counterattacks, 75%. Right? When you give the ball away, that's the best chance for the other team to score. Okay, most goals are not scored from us building up from the back, unless you're Barcelona. But even Barcelona, a lot of their goals, I wouldn't say maybe 75% of their goals, okay, but that statistically, 75% of goals in the game of football, it's scored in transition. When your team loses the ball, boom, they go score. You know, there's a game not too long ago, maybe a lot of you watched Man United versus Chelsea. A lot of Chelsea fans, Man United. Okay, who won the game? Man United won 2-0, right? Premier League game. Chelsea top of the league. Chelsea maybe a better team, right? You know, they've done better. But 2-0 Man United, okay? Chelsea 68% possession, no shots on goal. Man United, okay? 2-0, okay? A lot more opportunities on goal, a lot more dangerous, okay? How they score? Transition. So you can study, you can see, okay, that's why the modern football is, total football is, we want to have the ball, we're going to press. You know, back in maybe old times or, you know, older generation, a lot of footballers, there was a thing where you're forward, you have your three forwards, your right forward, your left forward, your center forward. Those guys didn't have to defend. You know, they didn't have maybe the task or the role, defensive role that nowadays we have. Okay, so that's the total football philosophy. So when we lose the ball in the attacking half, we want to win it back as fast as we can. That's why teams now high press, you know, make it more difficult to play. So so I'm taking you through here so that the what they do is they go run those positional play. Okay, now I'll explain that in a little bit, and then training games. So that was a practice there. So we go the cognitive process. Goes to the first one, okay, perceive. Okay, so it's the player's ability to recognize and understand. Okay, you can, you know, I know the print is small there, but hopefully you can read there. So it's when players scan and read the field, you know, see traces. So it's something you train, you know, it's not, at the end of practice, you're having the player think. At the beginning of practice already, you're training the mind. You're having players be aware of space, be aware of pressure, be aware of options, okay, and be able to perceive. You have to perceive the environment. You have to be able to scan. Okay, Hazard is very good, right? He plays out in the wing, but a lot of times you can see, look over his shoulder. Sergio Busquets for Barcelona, right? You watch him, he's a, you know, they say he's a maestro, right? So he's a guy that really makes them tick, plays, you know, if you watch some of the games they've been able to, teams that, you know, been able to beat Barcelona, don't let Sergio Busquets play. Pep Guardiola, when he coached, I mean, met, you know, a team full of best talent in the world, but he said, who do you want to be? I mean, who's your guy? He said, Sergio Busquets. So the role of players, the players that can perceive and scan the field, be aware, because then they can play at a higher speed, in a different tempo. The game slows down. So that's step number one. Step two is conceive. So that's when you start forming ideas. Okay, so, and this is all taking place, you know, very, very fast. You know, this is a continuous thing. So it's an immediate thing that must process, okay, and pose. Okay, so they're perceiving, they're conceiving, okay, then they decide. They have to make a decision. So we say a lot of times you have to think before, and you have to decide before what you're going to do with the ball before you get it. Especially coaching young players. If you coach young players, and even now, I mean, there's high-level players. A lot of times, we think when we get the ball, we react. Okay, we're not thinking before. And it's a simple thing, you know. Say yeah, but it's when you get out there, when you do a run, I can see, you know, right away who are the guys who have the IQ, who have the brain, who can scan the field, but also who can make decisions before. They can see. They can kind of anticipate. Okay, so. And then deceive Okay, that's an important one too. So if you're playing rondos, you know how much in the game, a lot of times you're going to fake people in there and you're playing there. So that's an element of the cognitive process as well. And then you execute, then you evaluate. Okay, so you can see the steps there that I just went through, the side. Okay, so you've got to determine a preference or come to a conclusion. Okay, deceive is to mislead. Execute, perform, or carry out. Okay, then evaluate to assess or judge. Okay, so make sense?
Yes.
Any questions? Now, this is very important now. So you have it on your sheet, there's 3CPP2 equals SP. It's not math. But it's the 3C model, okay? So it's the cognitive competence and character. Right here, 3C plus positional play plus principles of play equals system of play. So a lot of times we talk about formation, system, 4-3-3, 4-2-3-1, 3-5-2, okay? And we start a lot of times from here, this way, when we're trying to develop players. So there's a time and place where you know, Barcelona plays a 4-3-3, but they don't develop players going from here to there, okay? So what they do, you know, you have positional play and principles of play. So you teach positional play and you teach principles of play. That'll equal your system of play. Because even nowadays, in a game, you might say it's clear Barcelona plays a 4-3-3. Okay, but look at Real Madrid and a lot of teams, how much the game is dynamic. How much does it change within a match, within a half, within 10 minutes? Right? Have you seen that? Nowadays, a lot more. Right? Where you might say, you know, Real Madrid, you can tell, well, does Real Madrid play a 4-2-3-1, 4-3-3, 4-1-4-1, right? So we play, you know, a 4-1-4-1 system, but I'd rather, you know, teach players positional play and principles of play so that they can make decisions. They're responsible, they're intelligent, and they're technical to go over there and be effective. Because sometimes it requires you to adjust and have a different role. So within, you can might start on a 4-1-4-1 system, but one player drops in and it changes, right? So depending on how you can, who you're gonna play, okay? So there's a lot of that that comes into play. So as you can see there, you know, as you go through, there's a quote here from Xavi on positional play.